Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. In this playlist, we've seen the use of reagents like Br2 and Cl2 to make halohydrins. Let's see some other different reagents for accomplishing these same reactions. On the screen, we have a familiar alkene addition reaction, the synthesis of a bromohydrin by addition of Br2 and water. If you use Cl2, you would get the chlorohydrin by essentially the same pathway. These reactions work fine, but they do have some issues. First, Br2 and Cl2 are difficult reagents to handle. Second, both reagents generate strong acids, HBr and HCl, or in water, H3O+. You might think, who cares? We deal with strongly acidic reagents all the time. That's true, but not all molecules withstand soaking in strong acid. While you're doing your alkene addition, something on the other side of your molecule might be decomposing. To address these problems, chemists sometimes use a different reagent for making bromohydrins. That reagent is N-bromosuccinimide, the title of our slide, sometimes abbreviated as NBS. Here is the structure of NBS. Unlike Br2, which is a volatile liquid, NBS is a nice crystalline solid. To understand the reactivity of NBS, let's look closer at Br2 in our top reaction. I tend to think of Br2 as a bromine atom attached to a leaving group, which happens to be another bromine atom. An electron-rich alkene can attack our bromine, and the other bromine is kicked out as a leaving group. NBS is very similar. We have a bromine atom attached to another group that forms a somewhat stable anion when it leaves. That leaving group is the succinimide ring. The nitrogen that leaves has lots of resonance into the adjacent carbonyls. It might not be as good a leaving group as bromide, but it's still good enough for the reaction to work well. Fine, but how does NBS solve this acidity problem with Br2? Well, the succinimide ion is a bit basic. At the end of the reaction, when we form H3O+, the succinimide ion can react with that acid and neutralize it. So if the rest of your molecule is sensitive to acid, it will not decompose. Fantastic. Let's see a full example with NBS. Here is an alkene on the far left, that's cyclohexene, will react with NBS in water. Although we'll normally just write NBS, you'll need the full structure for a mechanism. Just as with Br2, the alkene attacks the bromine, a lone pair on bromine returns the attack, and the succinimide leave. So let's put the Br on the top face. The resulting bromonium ion is attacked and opened by our solvent, water. We now need a base to deprotonate the oxygen. I'm going to use the succinimide leaving group to do that deprotonation. And that gives us our bromohydrin, and we've avoided forming any strong acids. So here's what the succinimide, this is actually succinimide the molecule, with the NH. So NBS is often used to make bromohydrins. There is a chlorine version called NCS or n-chlorosuccinimide. It works well to make chlorohydrins. That's the story on NBS. While we've seen how it can make bromohydrins, NBS is actually a very versatile reagent, and we'll encounter it in other reactions as well.